So without further ado, here's the fabulous Johnny Cash.
Now I taught the weeping willow how to cry, and I showed the clouds how to cover up a clear blue sky. And the tears that I cried for that woman gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her drawl, southern drawl. Then I heard my dream went back downstream, cavorting in Davenport, and I followed you, big river, when you called. She's been here, but she's gone, boy, she's gone. I found her trail in Memphis, but she just walked up the bluff. She raised a few eyebrows, and then she went on down low. Now won't you bat it down by Baton Rouge, River Queen, roll it on. Take that woman on down to New Orleans, New Orleans. Go on, I've had enough, dump my blues down in the Gulf. She loves you, big river, more than me.
That's fine, John.
Thank you very much. That's a great song.
Welcome back to Nashville, too.
Well, nice to be back with all our friends again.
The folks really loved you being down at the Opry.
We had a ball, T. Conner.
Not only that, but you came back to town for another reason, too, didn't you?
I remember the first time I saw him. It was raining like crazy. Will and Tom went on and on about cars and music. I knew they'd be at that local diner. Boys like that from all of town always hung out around Johnny's. I felt like a total creep going just to see Will. After tons of time watching them, Tom caught me staring. How embarrassing. After that, Will actually called me over. After Tom left, Will and I ended up hitting it off. Tom did feel pretty awkward, said he had to go fix a tape or something. Will asked me to meet him at the record store next week to listen to some music. We met up at the record shop every day after school for a few weeks. We had a ball. Will showed me all kinds of new music. Everybody rocking, having a time until they bring on some better red cherry wine. He even gave me a necklace, a little locket. But soon after, I saw Will less and less. I started to ask around where he was. Tom said Will was real sick, and that's why he'd been gone so long.
I couldn't tell poor Ingrid how well Will was with broads. A new one every week or so. With the way she showed up at the record shop every day looking for him, it'd break your heart. Will's not a bad guy, he just doesn't want to settle. Ingrid was getting on my nerves though. She was head over heels desperate. Why must I be a
teen?
What do you think? That's too much. It's... You can't know that I like him. Why do I keep doing this to myself? I've been daydreaming about this boy for months. He'd take me out on a perfect date. I wish it happened in real life. Before Saturday date, she's never ready and I have to wait. I say, come on, honey, we've gotta go.
A month or so later, I saw Will at the record shop, but he barely recognized me. Turns out he was just like all the other boys. There was already another girl on his mind. I knew I had to end it there, even though I had been dreaming about this boy for months. Gonna flood you, big river, and I'm gonna sit right here until I die. I met her accidentally in St. Paul, Minnesota, and it tore me up every time I heard her drawl, southern drawl.
Then I heard my dream went back downstream, cavorting in Davenport, and I followed you, Big River, when you called.